So this is the light that was originally in the shed, and I was going to just take it down and put up a different light, but I've decided that I kind of like this. It had plastic, what I thought were plastic covers over it. I figured it was probably going to get damaged when I was taking it down. As it turns out, they're actually glass, and this is a really nice vintage light. The one problem was the starters didn't. Some of them weren't working. Some of the bulbs were burned out, so it only had one bulb actually that was working. And originally I thought it didn't have very good light, but when I played with it a little bit. I had a couple of the starters around. I managed to get 3 out of the 4 bulbs working, and I thought it had pretty good light. So I decided I was going to try and stick with it. But rather than continuing to put money into some of the old technology, I'm going to convert this to LED. So I bought, came in the mail, some of the terminals for the end. There are 2 different types of setups that you can use, maybe 3, but one is these ends are non-shunted, so that electricity comes in on one side, runs through the bulb, and goes back out on the other side. You could also set it up so that it's double-ended, so that the electricity goes in this side and out the other side, so it travels through the bulb in that direction. There are also bulb setups out there, that LEDs that you can put directly into the system, and they just supposedly just work. Now, I've seen some other YouTubers who have put them in, and by the time they finished making their video, they had stopped working. So I was a little bit leery about that because I didn't know how that got resolved. I also don't know how the starters figure in. This is, you know, an older technology. So I decided I just want to rip out all of this and just, I'm going to use the single-ended, shunted ends like this. They came in the mail a couple days ago. And we're going to put them right in there. So hopefully they fit. They look a little smaller. So we're going to check them out, see if they work. I decided to invest a few dollars in these before I actually went out and bought the bulbs, because I want to make sure that these fit and will work. Let's just try this one here. These do seem to work a little bit differently, as these have clips on the side that you have to squeeze. And these have a screw that hold them in place. Actually, it looks like you might be able to use the screw with this one as well. We'll see. I think I can take this whole panel out. Got those 2 screws out. Yeah, so that should work. That looks like that'll fit right in there. Let's see. So yeah, the clips will hold it in place. They are a little bit lower, but I think they're still going to clear this plate. That really doesn't make a difference. And I probably don't even really need the screw, but I have them, so I'm going to put them back in. I'm just going to take all of these out right away while I'm here. That's out, that's out. That one's out, okay. Yeah, when I was looking at it, all of this old wiring, you know, it's all cloth covered wiring and stuff, and I didn't want to put any more into the old technology. So very similar setup. All right, so we're gonna put this one in, that clicks in. This to me seems kind of like belt and suspenders, because you've got the clips that are going to hold it in place, but we're going to put these nuts on here anyway.
So that should hold it securely. And actually, I'm not going to go crazy because I still have to put the wires in the bottom here. So I know that they're going to fit, so I'm going to get them wired up and I'll install them. I'll bring you back. Okay, I went and cleaned up the bracket a little bit too. And as I was wiring up the tombstones, I realized this actually has four holes in it, so you can daisy chain these together. The video that I actually watched that was talking about how to do this, they were pre-wired, and so when they came out, you had to connect all four of the white wires together and all four of the black wires together, but this will work out better because we can chain them together. And this is just a piece of 14 gauge electrical. So then that's as big as it'll go. You don't want anything bigger than that in there, but I'm using that because that's what I happen to have. And you just poke that end in. This, like I said, this is as big as you'd want to go. There, it's a little snug, but that should be pretty good. So that's how we got two wires running from here to here. I'm going to put another one here. We'll run two from here to there, and the last one over here, and then I can run to power either from this one or that one. So I'll bring you back after I get the rest of those wired in. So now, as you can see, I have the rest of them wired in, chained together, ready for power. So now I'm going to reassemble the bracket back in the case. I'm also going to get rid of all of the unneeded electrical stuff, the transformers and the starters and whatever's down on this end, all this old wiring that has cloth cover. It's one of the reasons I was getting rid of it also, because one of these ends was broken. So, alright, let's get it back together. That. So all I need is this part. I can go back down there. This is all nonsense now. Much simpler. Also much lighter. It'd be a lot easier to hang than it was to take it down. All right, we're just gonna get that cleaned up, get it back together, we're good to go. And then I order the bulbs and get it hung back up. They were advertised on eBay as single-ended. They are not. So I am just gonna go and work with this. So unfortunately, that means I'm gonna have to change the wiring on the inside of the light, but I think I can still make these bulbs work. Let's see what we can do.